Hello and welcome to this quick tour of the App Builder on 21 version. So I'm going to log in into my Apex development environment and you'll see that there are four major components: App Builder, SQL Workshop, Team Development, and the App Gallery. Let's review the App Builder. I can create new applications, import existing applications, I've got a dashboard and various workspace utilities such as App Builder defaults, remote servers, manage backups, REST, and more. Also, on this page, you can find an About section, which includes a link to the documentation page. There's another section for tasks, and the migration section where you can upload forms applications in XML format, make annotations and track them. That way you don't lose any business logic. Since this is a new workspace, I don't have any applications to run or maintain. So I can either start by creating a new application or installing an application from the App Gallery. I'm going to choose one from the App Gallery, for example, Ptrack. Install this application, click on Install Package Application, and when the application is installed, I can unlock it. That allows me to view the pages and components of the application in the App Builder. Let's go to the App Builder, where is the application that I just installed. Let's have a look at this specific application. Here you can find a component to run the application, supporting objects, share components, utilities, and export or import the application. So you can run the application. Now let's see the supporting objects. This component allows you to package the application and the database objects needed in the application. When you install the application, it executes validations and executes the scripts. On the other side, when you deinstall the application, it also executes the installation script. Let's see the installation scripts for this particular app. You can create a new script or edit an existing script. There are also some upgrade scripts and the installation scripts to be executed when you install the app. Also, there are some tasks that can be useful for you. Let's see the shared components. You are going to find 9 sections. Application logic, where you can define applications, items, process, or computations to use across the app. Security, where you can define the authentication schemas, authorization, and access control for your app. Other components where you can create or edit lists of values, plugins, or email templates. Navigation, here you can define the navigation menu, breadcrumbs, or lists to use in your pages. User interface, you can define different attributes for your application, such as logo, navigation menu, or navigation bar. Also define the theme or templates in your application. Files to upload static application or workspace files. There are sources to create REST services, web source modules, or legacy web services. Reports to create report queries and layouts. And finally, globalization allows you to identify the globalization attributes of your application and translate your application in other languages. Utilities includes different features such as upgrade application, review the debug messages, and the advisor will help you to check the application and best practices. Expert Import allows you to import, export, or deploy remotely your application. Let's see a particular page. Here you can find the page designer. There are three main panes. Left pane includes tabs for rendering, dynamic actions, processing, and share components. Central pane includes tabs for layout, page search, and help. At the bottom, you can find three tabs for regions, items, and buttons, so you can drag and drop the component you need. Right pane displays the property editor. Use the property editor to update attributes for the selected components. If you want to show the component view, you can go to Utilities, click Show, and click Component View. You can drag and drop any of the tabs to organize it the way you prefer. There are other features such as go to another page, lock the page, create a page, pages as copy, delete the page, go directly to share components, save and run the page. In this video, I show you a quick tour around the app builder. Thank you for watching this video.